What it do? Dream Team, it's your boy D. Neal back with another review video because I love Lil Dicky and I've seen this before, but I want to review it anyway. Well, before we jump in, is Lil Dicky senior professional rapper featuring Snoop Dogg. Lil Dicky's like one of my top favorite artists. He's so funny, but his bars are top tier. I love to do it. But before we jump into this, what I need you guys to do is hit subscribe. Ring the notification bell so you know when the next reaction is coming. You need to know. I got social media here. Patreon here on social media if you want to follow me. Awesome. I love you. If not, awesome. I love you. On Patreon, we are doing daily reactions that are exclusively on Patreon. So if you want to subscribe, I'd be super appreciative and super thankful. If not, thank you for just putting it on YouTube. Put all the links in the description. All you gotta do is hit the link, follow me, talk to me, I'm human. I'll talk back. What we got, Lil Dicky? It's Snoop. I had to.
Hello, how can I help you?
Hi, my name's Dave Bird. I have an appointment today. It's probably under Lil Dicky, actually. I'm a rapper, so.
I love okay. This, song. I love this.
Snoop Dogg says here, Snoop Deal GG.
Oh, yeah, he's right down the hall. First door to your right. Give him a knock and he should be right with you.
Grab a seat.
Thanks, I'm Dave. Very nice to meet.
Dave, what it do? You can call me Dog. Let me just check your sheet.
No problem.
Let me just say, he looks just like he did in that, like, fighting game, Def Jam, fighting for New York. Like, Snoop looks just like he did in that game. I just have to say that, my bad. Okay.
So I'm Dave, very nice to meet.
Dave, what it do? You can call me Dog. Let me just check your sheet.
No problem, sir. Let me just say, I'm a big fan of the shit that y'all made. I can't lie, I've been thinking about this all day.
All good, there's a reason that we call Dave. Let me start with your background, where you come from.
Sure, I was undergrad down there in Richmond.
Before that.
Are you talking about my hometown?
Yeah.
I was born out of Philly, grew up in a little silly old town called Cheltenham. That's in the suburbs, upper middle wealth around.
So real shit, you ain't never had to struggle for much?
I wouldn't say it like that. We just had a different kind of trap.
Elaborate.
Well, I ain't never had a tool, but I had to be the man of school. Like I was doing shit I had to do. So when I finished undergrad, I'm cool and I could get whatever job I wanted.
But the job you wanted wasn't all that bumping.
Yeah, and I saw quick all the flaws that be coming when you grow like that. When you've been racing them rats, you ain't been making them raps.
So know what I'm saying? What I rock with in the beginning, know what I'm saying? So he like, hey, I grew up in the suburbs, like, know what I'm saying? And so Snoop Dogg like, oh, okay, so you ain't had a struggle. You ain't never been through no struggle or anything. And like he said, I wouldn't put it like that. We just had a different kind of trap. Know what I'm saying? He said, elaborate. Like, I had to be the man in school. Like, he had to make great grades. He had a lot of pressure. Got to make the grades. He said, know what I'm saying? When I finish undergrad, it's cool. And I can get whatever job I wanted. So you see him at his desk, like, man, like, he doesn't have any passion for the job he's at. But he was told his whole life, like, get the good grades. Get something with financial security. Get something that say, y'all know what I'm saying? So that he had a different kind of track. Okay,
I'm all the flaws that be coming when you grow like that. When you've been racing them rats, you ain't been making them raps.
Boo-hoo, what a hardship. How you pay to get the rap shit started?
Man, my bar mitzvah money, but don't diss me, buddy. I wasn't one of them youngins up on the block who had nothing to lose. I must have wanted this a lot, I had something to choose.
Look at that, I can see there's something to prove up in your ass.
Yeah, I guess.
That's enough of the past, what makes you wanna do rap?
Oh my God, it's the best, bitches let me drop on their breasts. Literally, I can reinvent myself. I get a form to project myself. It's never boring, every morning I wake up and try to best myself. I never gotta be suppressed or stealthy to express myself. It's kind of healthy.
Cool, now let me put you through a couple hypotheticals.
Sure.
In a club and a couple niggas threaten you.
I wouldn't do shit. And I don't even care what they gotta do with this.
Shut the fuck up, raps like life. If you wanna do this, then you won't get far acting like a little bitch.
Nah, that's my niche. Don't get offended by this. But that's the market y'all miss. That's the target I'll hit. And that's the heart of my pitch. I wanna do this whole thing different.
I know, you know Snoop. Snoop aggressive, you know Snoop came. He was raised in the hood, you know what I'm saying? So Snoop like, hey, like, yeah, you can't be in this game after like little bit, like, know what I'm saying? You gotta be hard. So if a couple dudes come up to you in the club, you gotta respond. If my guy Lil Dicky like, nah, like honestly I wouldn't do that. He said, but know what I'm saying, this is the market y'all miss. Yeah, and that's the target I'll hit. That's the heart of my pitch. I wanna do this whole thing different. I that's what I like about it. He's out of the box. Well, Dicky's not in no box. I love it. Keep going.
Don't miss. That's the target I'll hit. And that's the heart of my pitch. I want to do this whole thing different.
The fuck you mean you want to do the whole thing different?
I think traditionally people have been doing the job, the same kind of way for a long time.
But traditionally speaking, nice. This shit works, right?
No, I get that, good but I just think, you don't know if it could be working even better. And I think you should look at me as an opportunity to find that out.
I like it.
So what are your biggest strengths?
Well, my flow is crazy. I can switch that amazing. For example, I could be like, ain't nobody fucking with Lil Dicky when he get up on this shit and spit his ticket ridiculous. Ripping this shit like it's never been did, and the rhythm is never predictable, cause I can switch and deliver this shit in whatever cadence you bitches prefer.
Alright, I get it.
Top of that lyrically, I'm pretty damn clever. Go. Got a long bottom bitch called a hoe Neville. Bro. And I blew up from the jump, Derrick Rose. You can say I'm pretty smart, how I know better. And y'all been winning like Pistorius, it's no feat. Bro, I could go on and on, I'm taking over and they mad like father-in-laws.
Okay, enough of the punchline. That ain't showing me you different than the other guys.
Well,
it's crazy. You know what I'm saying? How he switched the rhyme scheme, how he switched the flow. He's capable of doing just bam. You know what I'm saying? You want punchline? I can give you that too. I blew it from the jump. Derrick Rose need. Cole, bro. Lil Dicky is so great, bro. All right. But okay. They say, Lil Snoop Dogg said, you ain't saying nothing. You ain't proving nothing. You know what I'm saying? So keep
going. Over and mad like father-in-law.
Okay, enough of the punchline. That ain't showing me you different than the other guys.
Well, I don't know if they can run it like that, but ain't nobody else doing funny type rap.
What's that?
Well, I could tell a story about my morning, watching Boy Meets World and jerking off to the Panga Lawrence like the 14-year-old of Panga.
Oh, this shit like a joke, you don't get it.
Nah, it ain't like that. I just happen to be a nutty, abundantly funny type of individual like as a guy. So when I get up on the mic, I ain't finna just lie. Real recognize real, right?
Yeah, I guess. So what you trying to do?
Bro, she is printing her cheeks and my guy is getting head by the watcher, bro. Oh my gosh, this label is crazy, bro. This label is crazy. Oh,
I get up on the mic, I ain't finna just lie. Real recognize real, right?
Yeah, I guess. So what you trying to do 5 years from now? Tell me about the dude.
Well, I don't care about the money, like it's the respect that I'm wanting. Honestly, I just want to be one of the greats, where they gotta bring a poya up every debate. I don't want to lead a game the same.
In a nutshell, what's your legacy?
Well, I want to be the dude that came in and made a stand-up rap with the random rap and a man like that. For the people that was anti-rap, yeah, the fans of rap started to recognize the anti-rap is ironically one of the real brands of rap left.
That shit sound pretty damn complex.
I guess I want to be the best, I just want to do it my way and turn a whole game sideways. People, you ain't gotta be resigned to the highway. You can make a path while these motherfuckers drive straight.
I ain't mad at that.
Well, thanks, man. That's my plan of attack. Just let me in and I'ma rap the plaques. And I ain't about to win them back to back. I'm about to win them like it's back to back to back to back to back till I stop rapping.
You ain't even sold a damn album yet, true. That's a lot of talk from a Wally vet, let alone a young book, nigga.
You misread me.
No, this ain't a book, nigga.
Well, that's one of my
You misread me. No, this ain't a book, man. You know what I'm saying? Lil Dicky said, I wanna be the best. I wanna be great. I wanna put plaques up on the wall, but I wanna do it my way. Know what I'm saying? I don't want to do it how everybody else did it because I'm not like them. And real recognize real, right? I'm just a nutty, abundantly funny type of individual. Know what I'm saying? So when I get up on the mic, I ain't finna just lie. I'm finna be me. But I do have a passion for this, and it's not about the money. I just want my name mentioned with the greats. I rock with Lil Dicky so heavy. All right, keep going. I hate saying I rock with Lil Dicky because. I'm
from a Wally vet, let alone a young rook, nigga.
You misread me.
No, this ain't a book, nigga.
Well, that's one of my flaws. I'm too competitive, dog.
No, you just fucking repetitive, dog. I get it, you trying to be better than all, but you aren't shit into Jettas and Paul.
I get that, I gotta prove myself.
No shit, you ain't done shit.
Think about that, dog. Only doing this a couple of years, one taping them like this.
This shit is alright for your first shit, but you don't know if it's your worst shit.
Well, you don't think finding out would be worth it?
It might be, it might not, but I'ma put your ass to work, kid.
It's alright for your first ish, but you don't know if it's your worst ish. You know what I'm saying? It's alright for what you drop, but you don't know if it's your worst stuff. And he was like, hey, you don't think finding out will be worth it? Hey, it might be, it might not.
Think finding out will be worth it?
It might be, it might not. But I'ma put your ass to work, kid.
Wait, like I have the job? Like, really?
Well, one more thing. Let me see if you can put a hook together. What would you do for the hook for this song?
You want me to make a hook up right now?
Do I look like the type of nigga that like repeating himself?
Okay.
Man, do the hook.
I'm about to be professional. Homie, I'm professional. So, maybe like a low voice type thing?
Nigga, that shit is garbage, man.
Well, you know, I feel like there might have been some upside to it, but I'm not good at thinking of things on the spot like that. Don't y'all normally, like, outsource for that kind of thing sometimes?
Whatever, man. You trying to smoke a blunt?
Right now?
Yeah.
Sure.
Dope. Well, I need to bring some weed here, please. Thank you.
You got it, Snoop. I'll be right there.
Thanks, Juanita. Super nice woman.
Nigga, why does everything you say sound so soft?
I really don't want to be spoken to like that.
Yeah, whatever.
Hey, I got y'all weed.
Damn, that's some great-looking weed. It's just so early.
Can I get you guys anything else while I'm here? Coffee, tea, head, bottle of water?
Dude, did you just say head?
Yeah. You ain't never got no head before?
I mean, it just feels like a lot right now. Well, what kind of tea do you guys have?
We got mint, raspberry, Earl Grey, English breakfast.
Actually, I'll take head.
I knew your little dirty ass wanted some head.
Bro, I rock with him so heavily. Lil Dicky is so funny, but he's so full of bars. He's so creative. That's why I really rock with him, man. This, and Snoop Dogg was so dope in this too, though. I love how it was like a conversation, and Lil Dicky's trying to convince Snoop to sign him to the label, and Snoop's like, no. I love the back and forth of it. We definitely gotta do some more Lil Dicky stuff. I mean, I've heard almost all of his songs, so they'll mostly be reviews, but I'll do them anyway. That's it for this one. If you guys have a favorite song or artist you want to hear me react to, please don't hesitate to drop it in the comment section down below. That's why they even made the comment section. Guys, hit the subscribe, but stop waiting. I know what you're thinking. I'll hit it later. I'll hit it on the next. No, hit it now. Ring the notification bell so you know when the next reaction is coming. I got social media here, Patreon here on social media. If you want to follow me, awesome. I love you. If not, awesome. I love you. On Patreon, if you want to subscribe. Sorry, we're doing daily reactions that are exclusively on Patreon, so I'll be super appreciative and super thankful, so please do. If not, thank you for your support on YouTube. I'll put all links in the description. All you gotta do is hit the link, follow me, talk to me. I love talking to you guys. You guys are the most incredible team on YouTube. See what you need. Out.